children, welcome back to our biology class. Today we will recollect the whole chapter, why classification. I hope all of you studied the chapter very well. Okay children, let's revise the chapter. Human beings show a tendency to classify things around them. We classify organisms based on their shape, color, size and hues. Next, taxonomic keys. The taxonomic keys are the scientific indicators used for identifying and classifying plants and animals. One of the most important taxonomic keys is the dichotomous key. In dichotomous key, each indicator has two possibilities of selection. First is by choosing the peculiarities of the organism to be identified, and second one is by proceeding systematically on can identify and classify the organism. Taxonomy. It is a branch of the biology that identifies organisms, classifies them on the basis of similarities and differences, and names them scientifically. The taxonomy helps to know about the relation between various groups of organisms. It also acquires a general idea about the plants and animals of various geographical areas. Moreover, it provides the evidences that are helpful to explain the stages of evolution of organisms, from the simple to the complex. Then next, we studied about some scientists who have made valuable contributions in the history of taxonomy. First, Aristotle. He is known as father of biology. He classified organisms as those with red blood cells and those without red blood cells. Second, Theophrastus. He is known as father of botany. He classified plants into annuals, biennials and perennials. Next, Charakan. He is known as father of Ayurveda. He wrote the treatise Charaka Samhita by including in it around 200 plants and animals. Next, John Ray. He recorded more than 18,000 plants in the book Historia Generalis Plantarum. Then he used the term species for the first time. Next, Carl Linnaeus. He is known as the father of modern taxonomy. He suggested the taxonomic hierarchy. He proposed binomial nomenclature, the scientific naming method for organisms. Based on similarities or differences, all organisms, including human beings, are placed in different levels of classification. It was known as taxonomic hierarchy. This is the taxonomic hierarchy proposed by Carl Linnaeus. The base, species, next genus, family, order, class, phylum, and kingdom. Species is the basic level of classification. Organisms of a species share maximum similarity of features. Organisms of similar species constitute the genus. Similar genus constitute the family, and families join to form the order. Various orders constitute the class. Related classes join to form phylum. All phyla constitute the kingdom. Kingdom is the highest level. Observe the illustration. There are some indicators are given. These indicators are based on the different levels of identifying the classification of cat. First, kingdom Animalia. It includes all animals. Phylum Chordata. It includes vertebrates only. Class Mammalia. It includes the vertebrates and they feed their young ones with milk. Then order Carnivora. The mammals that have teeth to tear off flesh are included in this group. and family felidae. Those with withdrawable claws along with the features of the order Carnivora are included in this group. Genus Felis shows features of the family Felidae. Small sized body, no roaring sound are included in genus Felis. Next species Domesticus. Here along with the features of the genus Felis shows unique features of the domestic cat. Children, let's wind up our today's class. Today we revised the contents of Y classification that we discussed in our previous classes. Okay, children, study well. See you in the next class. Thank you.